Hey, yo, what's good? Welcome back to Coach DT Reacts, man. Hey, so check it out. We took an L hard, all right? But at the same time, did it really matter? Yeah, it mattered to me, and I didn't like it at all. Let's check it out. Please like, share, subscribe to the channel. Comment if you are new. Let me know what you want to see, man. All right, we got some new folks in the comments. All right, want to know what you guys are looking to hear. So, before I can even get the intro over, it's 4th and 2. 3rd and 5. Yeah, I got held to 4th and 2. Yeah, man, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, man. We got good stuff, great stuff dropping every single day. Kind of like that. That's bad stuff dropping. That's terrible stuff dropping. Don't spike it now. How should I spike it before you got tackled? Come on, man. Short field for Washington. And this is a serious question. Who is Washington's quarterback? Howell? He's going to chatter, huh? No, he's going to run right across the freaking backer's face like the backer wasn't sitting there. That ain't chatter. Chatter I would have took. 3rd and 7. Dak's in the pocket. He's in trouble. We can't pass, bro. This is a four-man rush. Excuse me. All right. So my back chips and gets out into space. Look at my back chipping. All right, I'm trying to keep my composure here. What's wrong with angling this right here? Since you're widening the space, why not run an angle route right here and then attack the grass right here and make this guy come make a tackle with a tough angle? All right, so Dak and Tony Pollard are making eye contact right here. I'm trying to pause it too much. What's wrong with just throwing? So Dak's looking at. Dak's looking at this running back in space with enough time to really get the ball out. And what does he do instead? He looks backwards. He literally looks at the other end zone, completely the opposite direction of the person he could complete the pass to right here. There's nobody. I don't know why there's nobody on this side of the field. But there's nobody on this side of the field at all. And he should know that as a quarterback. Instead, third and four for Washington. Sam Howell dropping back. Oh, he has a guy. Oh, he dropped it. Never mind. He completely. Well, this is why they're 7 and 8. I got a punt right here. That's the way. Fair catch. Yeah. Fair catch. Just drops the ball. If I'm a punt returner in the NFL right now, I am very upset that this man is my Pro Bowler and I wasn't selected. Turpin has showed me very little this year as to why he was a Pro Bowl selection. I guess he had the most yards per punt reception, punt return. I'm not impressed, man. I'm not impressed. Not impressed at all. All right, Wardell just got listed as probable for Tuesday's game versus the Suns. Probable is a good thing, baby. Come on, Steph, let's go. All right, back to the Cowboys being completely just incompetent. You got cheerleaders on the sideline laughing at you, Turpin. Howell outside the pocket. Ooh, working, getting popped real good. Nowhere to go that time. Good luck. All right, 4th and 8. Washington going to tack on 3 more. He missed that. He straight shanked that. Nice. Okay. 7-0. What you gonna do with the opportunity? Is nobody getting open? What, I would love to see the... I do not understand. What the... So nobody has quarterback. Nobody. Nobody has the guy with the ball. Defense did. I'm not impressed so far defensively. Finally, a sack. My goodness. Second and 13. Washington on their 26. On the Cowboys 26, I should say. That's a face mask, more than likely. We're running into each other. Second and goal. Second quarter now. 13 minutes left. Pick! Woo! All right. Let's go. Finally, something good. It's okay if you just, you know, cover the person you're supposed to be covering. See, Trayvon. It's okay if you just cover the... I know you're trying to get this pick, right? But you gotta trust your teammates. And I think that's part of our secondary's issue, is they're not trusting each other to make plays. He almost misses the ball here because you're playing as good a defense as the receiver probably should have been playing. And where's Hooker going? Get down. My goodness. All right. Well, the defense is still able to force turnovers. We do that. I'm going to provide context. Many of you may not have watched the game yesterday, which is why you're here hanging with me. I appreciate that. So, prior to this play, I mean literally the very play before this one, Dak Prescott went to throw the ball to what I believe is the same receiver for what should have been an interception. And on the very next play, Dakota Prescott throws the ball right back over there, and the result is... I said this, and I'll say it again. I think our routes are basic. I'm gonna turn the music up because I don't want there to be any music when I say this. I think our routes are basic. We run outs. We run goes. We run fives. We run seams. All right. We run stops. We might run a corner. That's basic, man. We have got to get more creative. Please tell me that Kellen Moore is somewhere devising up something magical for the playoffs. Please tell me. But I'm not convinced. I'm not convinced, man. This is basic. Dak has got to be better. Dak has got to be better. It's a speed out, man. He has outside leverage. You want to run a speed out when he has inside leverage. What does that mean? You want the defensive back to be inside of your receiver, so when the receiver breaks out, all right, he's breaking away from coverage, not to it. Outside leverage right here, you do not want to throw an out to that. Look. And he's adjusting his leverage on the break right here. All right, he sees what you're doing. He knows what you're doing. Eyes in the backfield the whole time. Can we do anything besides look at the same? This is look. Let's see if my quarterback throws the ball. Let's see if he throws where his eyes go. So on the snap of the ball, my eyes are looking right here. Gee, I wonder if everybody on this side of the defense knows what's coming. Yeah, he jumps it. Not to mention, hey, young receiver. You know what you can do for your quarterback here? By the way, this ball's not going to get here anyways. You could run this route and come back downhill towards the ball. Dak throws the ball before it even has a chance to come back downhill towards it, though. So, really, that's not your fault. That's not his fault in this regard. But please, if you're running an out route, shave. We call it shaving. Shave back downhill so that when you work this route, you're coming back down towards the quarterback and not climbing vertical, giving this defensive back an opportunity to get up under the route. Yeah, he sees it the entire time because Dak looked that way the entire time. All right, you see a lot better here. All right, you want Noah right here to come downhill back towards the 25-yard line. All right, you see he's climbing. And if he was here, then maybe the ball pops him in the chest right here, or at least he has a chance to play defense. But because he climbs vertical right here, and he climbs, instead of going from, let's say, the 28 to the 25, he goes from 28 to 30. Pick six, baby. Pick six. 13-0, Washington. Nice catch and run there. Nice catch and run by Dodson. Yeah, I guess I'm going to start analyzing the Washington Commanders offense. You could make a tackle, but instead you are making a speed turn. That's a nice speed turn. But I like tackles. 3rd and 11. And I'm not talking about offensive tackles either. I like those too, though. Not going to get it done. 3rd and 11 brings up. Man, the Cowboys got the ball back. 13-0. Dak in the pocket. Still not finding anyone to throw it to. Got Schultz. And yeah, I don't know why it was so casual. Let's get up and get yak. Good job by Schultz. That's a good pop right there. Good throw, good catch. Oh, would you look at that? He had outside leverage, so we ran an inside route. It's almost like we're coached up or something. It's almost like the offensive coordinator is making adjustments. All right, based on the defense that he's being shown. All right. So what I'm talking about here, all right, defensive back has head up to outside leverage. That gives me an inside angle. All right. He's widening. So what do? I break in. Huh, I'm open. Beautiful. I might get hit, but I'm wearing a helmet. That's helmet to helmet, by the way. That is helmet to helmet. I'm not someone that's soft. I played lots of football before they even considered helmet to helmet an illegal thing. But that's helmet to helmet. If we're going to call it, let's call it. 3rd and 10. Behind the sticks. Sitting in a pocket. Good. Good. First down to Schultz. Good job. Good pocket there. Good pocket. A four-man rush should not get home. Come on, man. Good. Good look right there. Four-man rush should not get home. Good. T.Y. Hilton. Little combo route. Finding holes in the defense. Good look. Like seeing Hilton get out there and get some yak. Get a catch and some yak. 9 seconds left. Ball. Let's go. He had like he afraid to throw the CD. Are they doubling CD every time or something? CD does a good job right here. All right, on the break, on the snap, he widens here. He widens. I need a draw tool. That's what I need. He widens right here, and then he sticks it and gets inside right there. All right, once the leverage is created, boom, right there. Leverage created. And this guy is out of the play. Only one that can make a play is Butler, the safety. Good look right there. Good ball by Dak. I'm going to say that very much. Wide, stick. Yeah, nothing. His eyes are in the backfield. They want to catch picks. Good ball. Dak did a good job here of throwing CD away from the hit. He's protecting his receiver. That's a good ball. All right, throws him down to the ground. All right, this safety doesn't go over here and put helmet to helmet. He's trying to. CD gets down, protects himself, touchdown. Good look. 13-6. 3rd and 1. Good rally. Let's go. Good rally. That's what we're talking about, man. We gotta have bodies to the football. Early in the season, we had bodies to the football. All right, we were rallying to the football quickly. I need more of that. Third and 12. Dak. On 3rd and 12, why do we do this? Does anyone have an answer for me? Please comment down below. Comment down below if you know the logic behind the 3rd and 12 heave. Some may say it's to try to draw a flag. Like, pass interference, you know. Okay. If you're going to give me that logic, okay. But I feel like 3rd and 12 is a manageable down for a decent quarterback. And there should be something in our playbook that we can get 15 yards off of as a NFL, as a professional National Football League team. We should be able to get 15 yards. It's not easy, right? But we should be able to draw up something that's not a Hail Mary, in my opinion. Let me know if I'm wrong. Let me know if you think I'm wrong. Maybe I am wrong. Maybe that's your best bet on 3rd and 12. Oh, would you look at that? That's a pretty decent play on 1st and 10, for sure. Not sure if that would work on 3rd and 12. Oh, how? Dropping dimes. Good ball there. That's the first down. 2nd and 14. Something happened here. Sam Howell is 9 of 14, 97 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 interception. Oh, good ball. So we're not covering. Good ball. We're not covering. Oh, I see now. We're stuck in quicksand. Look at this man's feet moving, and look at our feet not moving. And the second you open that hip, guess what he's going to do? He's going to go here. Yeah. Yeah. Because you can't close that hip and beat him to a spot right here. He's naked. Good route. Yeah, good route. Yeah, watch this. Option. Excuse me, the option is inside this time. Yeah, baby. Yeah. 2nd and 4. Sam Howell handing the ball off. Oh, good internal run right there. And he's not down? No, he's laying on top of a cowboy right here. Yeah. Yeah, he's still going because he's not down. The whistle hasn't blown. 1st and goal. Yeah, it is. I'm embarrassed. Sam Howell, which respect to Sam Howell, of course, because he's an NFL quarterback and he's on the field, so he's a dog, obviously. But Sam Howell just ran through the teeth of our defense on an option route that went to the right and scored on the left side. He also ran over my all-pro cornerback. Excuse me. You ran over. You ran over. And you're also down by 2 scores now. And they still can't kick a PAT. Why would I look back at it? All right. Sam Howell dropping back. Getting ready to drop a dime on us. Yeah. Yeah. That's a ball ball. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. Sam Howell is embarrassing us. 14 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Sam Howell, low ball there, incomplete. So we were able to get a stop. And by stop, I mean keep them to 3 points. It's now 23-6. We're in the fourth quarter of what I would like to believe is a competitive football game. It is not a competitive football game. Passing yards. 158 for Washington, the Commanders, and 83 for Dallas, the Cowboys. I hope that's not a trend. Hope that's not a trend we're starting here, because I promise you Tom Brady's going to get more than 158 passing yards. Dak Prescott pops it in on Schultz. Ball comes out, but I think it was forced out on the ground. That ball's high and behind, and T.Y. Hilton does a really good job with it. Oh, blitz coming, and so we get the ball out hot. Beautiful. CeeDee Lamb fighting for yak. He gets a lot of it. 3rd and 2. 4th and 1. Coming up. Now, we're going to QB sneak here. We should be able to get the first down on 4th and less than a foot. Nice run. Washington's O-line does a good job blasting us off the freaking football, to be honest. Soft. The line of scrimmage being dominated by Washington. I got a backer sitting here that's 3 yards deep. Got another backer 4 yards deep with a man in his chest. Another backer 2 yards deep getting worked. And we've walled off the backside right here. And by we, I mean the Washington Commanders. Out of the play. Too slow for the line of scrimmage. Great cut. Great cut. Great cut. Using his big bodies. Big bodies doing a good job up front for Washington. 3rd and 4. Got him down. 3rd and 4. Good look. 4th and 2. Boom. Ball through for Washington to make it 26-26. Okay. Shooting a smoothie everywhere. Oh, Washington has the ball back. Oh, had the ball back, I should say, right? Yeah, that's embarrassing. 3rd and 3. Blasted right there, but good run. I'll you know what? At least he's trying to do something. All right, comment down below. If you think the Cowboys are going to get booted in the first round, comment a boot. If you think they're going to get booted in the second round, comment 2 boots. Nah, man, listen. In my opinion, they mailed it in the last 3 or 4 weeks. In my opinion, I think the Cowboys realized that at some point in the last 3 or 4 weeks that their future was set, and they were going to be the 5th seed no matter what. And so they decided to mail it in. I think we haven't been running the ball hard. I think we've been trying to get offensive linemen healthy, defensive linemen healthy. I think we've had snaps cut. I think Dak has kind of checked out and is really zoned in on Tampa Bay, who I believe we've known for a few weeks now was more than likely going to come out of the NFC West Division, or East, sorry, NFC West Division. And so I hope so, man. I have confidence in this team's highs. Let me say that again. I have confidence in this team's highs. When this team is playing well, this team can play with, in my opinion, anybody in the league. Man, when this team is playing bad, we are a bottom feeder sometimes, it feels like. Bottom feeder. I'm talking any given Sunday. Someone can beat us when we're playing bad. And you've seen it with the Texans. You saw it with, actually, let's give respect where it's due. The Jags team ends up being a pretty solid Jags team. They got it together, kind of were putting it together right there at the end there. This Washington team, though, they're 7-8 before this game. They're now 8-8-1 on the season. Their season is over. But they managed to leave a sour note on us. So got to put this behind us. We have a Tampa Bay squad that has not had a great season, but that doesn't matter. All right, when you're playing the Dallas Cowboys, because we may beat ourselves. And you know Tom Brady's not going to beat himself. So with that being said, let's look at these statistics really quick. While we're looking at the statistics up, let me talk about DeMar Hamlin real quick. Refreshing this bad boy. Listen, if there's anything you can do, all right, to give to DeMar Hamlin's charity, man, please, please do what you can, right? Great news today. He came out of the hospital today in Cincinnati and was on his way, I believe, today to a hospital in Buffalo, right? So that's great news. That's signs of positive things to come, positive things that are currently happening. And you freaking love to see it. So if you're the praying type, keep those prayers rolling. If you're not the praying type, man, I appreciate you sending good vibes to a young man that is doing what he can to survive, doing what he can to fight, to become better overall. All right, so shout out DeMar, man. Keep fighting, all right, from one footballer to another. Man, it's all love, and you are an inspiration to all of us. All right, with that being said, let's take a look at these boxes, at these scores. Let's see. Cowboys versus Commanders. Oh, that's ugly. That's ugly. All right, so. Dak Prescott threw 14 for 37, 128, one touchdown. One of my buddies said, worst Dak Prescott game ever. I agree. Tony Pollard had 7 carries for 19 yards. Let's see, what else? Cooper Rush was 0 for 1, nothing. Zeke had 8 carries for 10 yards, nothing. They literally blasted us at the defensive line, with the defensive line. Man, look at this. These are not the stats of people trying to win ball games, in my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong on that, and we come out and we get blasted by Tampa Bay. But, man, I think that this team is way better than they showed. Sam Howell, 11 of 19 for 169, one touchdown and one interception. Sam Howell also rushed for a touchdown as well. Terry McLaurin had a touchdown. Not bad for Washington. They had a lot more to fight for than we did, clearly. So, that being said, man, please like, share, subscribe to the channel if you're new. All right. Appreciate you coming back if you are a returner. All right. Things are looking great. Things are growing. We're excited about where this thing is going, man. Really, really excited about where it's going. Let's see. While I got you, like I said, check out DeMar Hamlin's charity, or if you got anything to give. If not, please just share, man. Just share the video and let us know exactly how you feel about, you know, let us know exactly how you feel about a great opportunity to make a difference like that. So with that being said, it's been Coach DT. All right, peace. Roll that outro.